Hello everyone, this is Saurabh Maheshwari and we are continuing the C programming classes with the basics of C programming 3. In this particular video, we will see how to do input and output with the help of scanf, printf. Then we will see how to get input of characters with the help of getch, getche and getchr. So let us open the code blocks, and in code blocks how you are going to create a new file, you will click on this icon or you will go in this file menu or new file, and in file you will take C++ source file and you will click on go. Okay, you can skip this page and next. In next you will select C programming, next, and then here you will write your first program. So here you will write, suppose we will write input1.c. okay, and it also requires file name with full path. So this will be, you have to choose file name with I have chosen it 1920 programs, so I will just create another folder 2021 programs. Okay, so in this I will create this file. Okay, and finish. Now this file is created. Once you have created and created a new folder, you can directly click on Ctrl Shift and N to create a new file. Okay, and when you save it, you save it with the help of .c. okay, so I will save it as input2.c. okay, we will do something in this program later. Okay, now let us come on this input1.c. and now we will see how to take input with the help of scanf and printf. Input and with the help of scanf, and then output with the help of printf. Okay, so we will start with writing a comment that program for input and output demonstration. Okay, so as you remember, I told you that all the programs start from this hash include. Okay, this hash include is pre-processing identifier, and include is a keyword in C programming which helps you to include a inbuilt directory in your program. Okay, so here we will take stdio.h, okay, standard input output.h as our program directory. As a library. Okay, then we will write void main. This is default function. Main is a default function where your source code of main source code is written here. Whatever logic you plan, whatever algorithm code for algorithm, we see, we saw in the previous videos that how to write an algorithm and pseudocode for a particular algorithm or particular solving a problem. Here we have code for, this is the place where we write the main code for the algorithm. Okay, now I will declare int. Int is a keyword which is used to declare integer. Let us say I declare integer a, and I also declare integer b. Can you see there is a comma separator which is just between declaring two integers? Okay, so integers a comma b, this means you have created two integers a and b. Okay, now I want to take information or the values of this variables from the user. Okay, before that, let us take this. Okay, so I have given the value directly in the initialization, directly in the declaration. Okay, so without this, this is called declaration of variable. Okay, and if I give its value, the first value given to a variable is called initialization of the variable. Okay, b is not initialized right now, We will see that if a variable is not initialized, what is its value. We will see it sometime. Okay, now you can see first value is given. The initialization can also happen in the same line also, then you don't require this line. Okay, fine. Now let us see what is the value of print, what is the value of two variables here. Okay, so this is the syntax of printf. What you have to write, printf is the name of the function, opening parenthesis and closing parenthesis, and between that there is a double quotes. Okay, so this is type 1 printf. Okay, type 1 printf means printing a constant string only. Okay, so what does it mean? Whatever you write here, okay, so suppose I write here the values of variables are, okay, I will, if I do this, okay, and let us print this. Okay, you go in build, how to run the program. You first build the program. Okay, building simply means you compile it and create the object file for this. Okay, then building is finished. Okay, if there are zero errors, zero warnings, okay, so there are zero errors, it means the program is free from errors, you can run it. Okay, these two things can be done from here also. Okay, so you can directly go here or you can go in build and then click on run. Okay, so if your errors are zero, you can go in build and run it. Okay, as soon as you run, you get a console window in front of you. This console window shows you the output. You can clearly see the output here. The values of the variables are whatever you written in the printf. Okay, in type 1 printf, whatever you have written between the double quotes, that goes printed on the screen. Okay, so this, in this way the printf, type 1 printf works. Okay, but suppose I want to print the values of the variables also. So this is type 2 printf. Type 2 printf is what? Printing values of variables. Okay, printing values of variables. Fine, for that we require the values of variables are, I will make this line comment so that now this line does not run and I want to run this line. So the values of variable are %d. You can see why I have written %d, because this is integer and I told you that the format specifier is for integer is %d. The printf requires format specifier, okay, and %d. Okay, so what does it mean? You want to print two integers. Okay, so what you have written, the values of variables are %d and %d. Now what does this %d means? It tells the compiler that two integer format values are going to be printed here. Now whose values will come? That will come as a part of second parameter of printf. Okay, in type 2 printf, okay, you write the variables whose values are going to print it. It works in the same order. The first printf in this string, okay, is taken, it takes value of the first variable, and the second %d will take the value of the second variable. Okay, now if I run this program, okay, I can choose build and run together also using this option. Now here you can see that the output is somewhat unexpected. Okay, it is different from the previous case where only the text was there, but here this %d has been replaced by the value of a, that is 4, and the second %d has been given the value 8. Okay, but this has to be the value of b. Okay, but b value is not available, b value is not given anywhere. Okay, so if b value is not given, then how this value came? Okay, let us run this program again. We just press enter here, then again let us see what the value comes this time. Okay, it is again 8. Okay, so for this particular program, the b has been allocated a memory, okay, where the previous value, or I can say the garbage value, is written as 8. Okay, I told you earlier in the previous classes that whenever you declare a variable, a memory is allocated to the variable. Okay, and whenever this memory is allocated and it is not initialized, okay, like in this case, and a b is not initialized, so the allocated memory will have a previous content. Okay, you can understand this with the help of this example. Suppose you are going to buy a new house. Okay, now you have taken a new house, you have done a registry, so it means you have declared that the new house is here. But until unless you go and start living there like this, here A and B, both houses were purchased, but A put its luggage at the new house, so the new house shows his luggage. But until unless B does not given a initial value, or the luggage at the B is not placed, so the old luggage or old furniture, old everything, the old values of B which were there in the memory, okay, so they are taken. So in this case, the memory which was allocated is having value 8, so that is why it is printing 8. Now if I initialize it with the help of 5, okay, and then I execute it, okay, run is also called execute. Now you can see the difference, that the values are 4 and 5, so the expected values are coming. Okay, so always make a good practice of initializing the variables. Okay, so I have shown you the two uses of printf. Fine, this one printf, there's a type 1 which is only used to print the strings, and then the type 2 which is used for printing the values of the variables. Okay, now just doing some variations, if I take value of A to be, value of B to be 65, okay, now B is an integer, but by chance I put here C, percent C is used for character. Fine, now according to you, according to the concept that we know till now, that percent C is used for character type, so it should produce an error. Okay, but this is not an error. Let us try to execute it. Okay, so you can see here that the result is, all first thing is that this thing is printed twice, the values of variable, because both the printfs are active. Okay, so first this is printed on the screen, then at the next place this is printed on the screen with this. Okay, now the thing to be noted here is that 4 is value of A and this capital A is value of B. Capital A is a character, and what happened, the value of B is to be an integer, and suddenly when you printed it in the character format, okay, so that gives you 65. Okay, so this is the thing that you can observe here, that the integers and characters are interconvertible with the help of their ASCII values. Okay, ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange. We talked about this in our previous classes. Okay, so what happens here? B, whose value is 65 here, okay, so that is converted to the character, and the character equivalent of 65 is capital A. So if I take this value to be 66, okay, so it is a continuous values, so it should be B now. 65 integer value stands for capital A, and then you can see that it has changed to B. So the ASCII value ASCII value 66, okay, integer value 66 is of the value of capital B. Okay, similarly, if the value of this B is 97, okay, these are special values, you have to remember this. Okay, so you can see that a small a is printed. Okay, so 97 is small a and 122 is small z. So 97 to 122 is the range for small or lowercase letters, and 65 to 90 is the range of capital or uppercase letters. Okay, now this is the variation, simple variation I told you about that. Fine, and if I take the value to be 48, okay, let us see what happens. You can see that 0 is printed. Okay, 0 is the symbol 0, okay, character 0, it is printed because the numbers are from 48 to 57, 0 to 9, okay, 0 to 9. So the ASCII values of the digits B equals to 57 means it is printing 9, na? B equals to 57, it is printing 9, and 9 is a character, okay, 9 is a symbol, okay, that is not an integer. Okay, B equals to 9 is a different thing, okay, but B equals to 57 means integer value is 57, and if I convert it into character, it converts to a character 9. Okay, then if I directly printed integer, it is not going to change anything and it is going to print 57. Okay, so this is a simple program of outputting various integers and characters, and the variation is in the form of character equivalent of the integers. Now when I run it, another thing to observe is that as soon as the output of first printf was ended, the next printf starts on the next place. Okay, so we have some escape sequences by which you can control the new lines. Okay, so the first escape sequence that I am telling you about is backslash n. Okay, so whenever you place backslash n, you use this backslash n gives a new line in the output. Okay, so the values of variables are, and then a new line is created, and then the next printf is printed. Okay, now similarly we have backslash t. Backslash t is for tab. Okay, so let us see how the output looks like. Okay, so it is not giving you the new line, but it is giving a tab space. Okay, tab is a fixed number of spaces, so that is given over here. Okay, you can directly add some spaces by your own also, so that number of spaces will also come over here. Okay, the number of spaces that you give here, that will come in the output also. Okay, so in this way, this works like this works, these format specifiers and the escape sequences works. Okay, now we have seen the printf. Now let us see scanf. Okay, so I can now comment these printf, or I will use these later. So let us now indicate the user that enter the values. Okay, so this can be a command, or this can be an indication to the user that he is to enter the values. Okay, now whenever user enters value to the console, we require, okay, we require this function scanf, and this scanf has a syntax as this, okay, and comma. Okay, here compulsorily this comma comes because whatever you are going to scan will go in the variables. Okay, now here we write format specifier, and then we write the name of the variable with this particular operator. This operator is called address of operator. Okay, because we are storing a value, so we tell the compiler that the value which will be taken in the integer form will needs to go to the address of this particular payload. Okay, so in this way we are going to scan A, and similarly if I copy this line and paste it up. Okay, so in this way we are going to scan A and B both. Okay, the same thing could have been done in the same line also, percent D, and there you will write percent M percent B also. In this case this new line is not required. Let us see how this works. So whenever you run this, you can see that on the screen enter the values is written and the complete program is not run. Okay, it stops or waits for your input. Okay, because of this scanf statement. Okay, this scanf statement requires two values. One, the first value that you will enter will go in an integer format and will be stored at the address of A, and the second value will also be taken in an integer format and it will go to the address of B. Okay, so I will write 4, then I will put space, then I will put 6. Okay, so I have entered two values, 4 and 6, and then I will press enter. The command that is used to execute scanf is enter. Okay, so this scanf percent D. So can you see this 4, the first value that I entered went to this percent D, and this percent D or the scanf stored the value to the address of A. Then this 6 goes to this percent D, second percent D, and the scanf stores this value to the address of B. And when I print now A and B, you can see the new values, earlier values were 4 and 57. So by chance we gave the value of A of 4. So I can run it again also. Let us run it again and try to give a different value. Suppose I give value 7 and space and 32. Okay, so if I give this value, you can see that the values are printed as the new values. So what happens? The earlier values before this scanf statement, before this input, are overwritten by the newer values. Okay, so in programming, or the concept of memory is that the memories are always overwritten. Unless the memory is overwritten, its content are safe. Okay, nothing is deleted. Okay, whenever you delete a movie from your pen drive, it doesn't mean that you have deleted the movie. Okay, it simply means your system is forgetting the movie. Okay, the movie already also exists here, and when you copy a new movie at the same place, then only the previous movie is overwritten. Okay, so similarly happens here. The previous movie which was forgotten is called a garbage. Okay, so whenever you not declare not initialize any variable like this, so this B is going to take the garbage value which was already available at the allocated space in the memory. Okay, so this is the concept of input and output. You can use scanf for input. Achha, it is important to place this address of operator, right? If you are not going to put it, this is not going to produce an error. Okay, this is not an error, because you can see that the program will build normally. Okay, it is not going to give you an error. Okay, there are zero errors because this is not part of syntax, but this is a logical error because you want to take input and store to an address. So that is why you have to put ampersand before the name of the variable. Okay, so in this way the input from scanf and printf is taken. Now let us take input of a character. Okay, in the same program let us declare, okay, or inputting a character. Okay, so let us create another program where we will create input, a program input and output for integers. Let us take this program like this. Okay. Now similarly, if these were not integers, but these were floats. Okay. So float happens to be same. Okay. But the values to be taken as %f, %f, and when you print them, the printing also needs to be done with the help of %f, %f. Okay, and you can also observe here that you have given the values as integers, but when you try to print them, they will come directly as a float. Let's see. If I run it and I enter the value as 6 and 7, okay, you can see that the values comes as the floating point as 6 point and 6 decimal after decimal, 6 places accuracy is there. Okay, and the value of 7 converts into 7.0. So what happens, you entered it in 6, but compiler takes it in the form of float. Okay, compiler takes it in the form of float. So what happens if I take input as d, it is going to give you unpredicted values. Why? Let us see. If I run it, okay, and I give value as 6 and 7, you can see that the value is coming as 0, because you are giving 6 and the compiler is also understanding it as a 6, because you have given that understand the value as an integer, and we are trying to store an integer to a floating point value, means a smaller value is going to place in a bigger vessel. Okay, so in this way the compiler does not understands the value or does not takes the value properly, so you have to choose the proper format specifiers. Okay, so in this way you can take the float variables also. Fine, so I will keep it at end at the integer only. Now let us do input a character. Okay, so initial statements are same, include stdio.h, then I will write void main. Okay, I will explain it later that what is this void main, because this is an important concept, but that is related to different topics. So we will, for right now, you can remember that the main the code for the algorithm is written in the main only. Okay, now I declare a character, suppose character is ch. Okay, now as soon as you write this statement, it is equivalent to writing integer a. Okay, here a new integer was created, here new character is created. Fine, and if I want to initialize it also, I can write character ch equals to a. Okay, now this creates a confusion. What is the confusion? That it looks like this is a variable. So to differentiate between name of the variables and characters, single quotes are used. Okay, so whenever you are giving a value to a character variable, it is given as a single quote. Okay, in the program. Okay, so ch equals to character a. It is character a. It is not a variable a. So you can take it like this also. Char a. Suppose this is a character also. Now writing this ch equals to a is a different thing. This statement is different and this statement is different. What does here mean? It means you are assigning character a to ch, and it means you are assigning variable a to ch, and variable a can have another value, suppose 0, okay, or 7. Okay, 7, this is 7. Okay, now 7 doesn't mean it is 7 as an integer. Okay, if I had to write 7 as an integer, I would have written like this. Okay, but this is not the case. This 7 is a character. Okay, now if this statement is run, so what will happen? Ch will have the value 7, because you have assigned this 7 to ch. Fine, so this can be a confusion in the initial days of programming, but you have to remember this thing, that all the character constants, these are called character constants, and whatever we written here like this, these are called integer constants, and whatever is written inside double quotes is called string constants. This is called string constants. Okay, fine. So ch equals to a. Now if I want to scanf also, so scanf, I have already told you that we can write percent c, okay, and ampersand, and in which variable ch, suppose I want to get input, so I will write like this. Sorry, I will write like this. Okay, in this, writing this statement helps us to take a character format value and store it in a character variable, address of the character variable. And if you want to printf, printf can be done very easily, percent c and ch. Okay, in printf ampersand is not written because we are only using the value, not storing the value. Okay, so this, in this way you can easily input the character. There are other methods also available to input a character, like ch equals to, just let us have a demonstration of this. Sorry, let us have a demonstration of this. Okay, now here no instruction is printed because I didn't give you any printf statement before that. So here we have to write some input. Suppose I write capital T, okay, and I give enter, so that T is printed. So the first capital T that I gave as an input went to percent C and percent C, and the scanf stored the value capital T into ch. Here you can notice I have not given single quotes, okay, so the single quotes are not required in the input console. Okay, they are only to be written in the program only to differentiate between the name of the variables and the characters. Fine, so in this way we give input. Okay, here we can write an statement, printf enter a character, right? So this will help you to give input. You can notice that I am writing semicolon at the end of every statement. Fine, so this is, semicolon is a special operator which is placed in the end of every statement. Okay, so this is, you have to remember that semicolon needs to be placed. If you are not going to write semicolon, this is going to produce a syntax error. You can see it produces the line number, just the line just after the error. Okay, so semicolon, it is showing 12 number line, so it is not 12 number line, it is line number 11. Okay, let us build again. So it is going, showing at line number 11, so the error is not at line number 11. When the compiler tries to come at line number 11, it finds that a semicolon is missing at the line number 10. Okay, so in this way this error is removed. Okay, many students does this error. Okay, another error is of missing this particular parenthesis, that is end of the main. Okay, this is also going to produce an error because declaration of end statement in function main. Okay, so this is going to produce an error. Okay, so you always remember whatever braces you have opened, the same number of braces you have to close. Okay, so for this it is always essential to simply put the opening and closing braces together. Although code blocks takes this responsibility by its own, but if you are using another compiler, so always remember that this and this, the opening and closing parenthesis should be there. Okay, also try to do this indentation. You can see that the closing parenthesis is shown just below the opening parenthesis. In this way you can easily manage that this main starts here and ends here. So this is, and all the statements are one tab after the line of the main. This is called indentation of the code. Okay, so this indentation you have to maintain, and it is not an error not to maintain any indentation. But yes, the program looks very good, easy to debug, easy to, if someone else sees this program, he can also manage to find the error or understand the program properly. Okay, it is like commenting is not a compulsory thing, but we do comment. So we do comment so that another person who will read this program will be able to know what this program is all about. Similarly, indentation is also a feature that you have to do. So how I have done indentation, you just put whenever you come in the next line. Okay, the code blocks always do indentation, but if the cursor is here, you just put tab and you will come here. Okay, so in this way indentation can be done. Okay, so let us see another methods of inputting a character other than a scanf. So if I don't use a scanf, okay, I can use ch equals to get char. The first function that we can use is get char. So you can see here get char is written. So get char works similar to scanf. Whenever you write get char, it takes the value as an input. Okay, let us see. I build it, no problem, and then I run it. Ch enter a character. If I write y, capital Y, then y is taken as input and it happens. Okay, so get char, and similar, it is similar to scanf. Okay, command is and enter, command is enter button. Okay, so to give the input with the help of get char, you have to take in, you have to give command as enter. Okay, now there is a problem here. Now if I have two characters ch and a, and let us take the, let me show you the problem why we need some more input methods. So if I do scanf and then again scanf, so if I place two scanf for scanning the, for inputting the characters, so if I write like this a, okay, and I want to print them also, suppose I print them both. Okay, so here if I run this code, now see it very carefully. I write first input as f, then I press enter, and you can see it is not asking for the second scanf. Okay, it is simply printing this f and nothing is printed. Okay, so what is happening here, that this first scanf runs, and after this scanf, after this scanf I press enter. So this enter, since this enter is also a character, it vents to the person C, and the scanf, this next scanf stores this enter to the character, to the variable A, and in due to this reason, this person C prints the value of CH, which is, which we gave as F. Okay, but this doesn't print anything. This person C does not print anything. And why it doesn't print anything? Because a enter, enter is not shown here. But you can see that a new line, a line is here. Okay, if I give, if I have given a proper statement, suppose this, then it doesn't come to the new line. Okay, there is no new line, but because this value of a is enter, and enter gives you the new line, so that is why this percent c prints the new line. Okay, so this is a problem with scanf, that the enter given in the command is dangerous for the input at the next character. Okay, this does not happens when you take the edit format of percent d. Like after one character scanf, if the next input is percent d, then there is no harm, but if the next input is character only, then there is a problem of this kind. Okay, the same problem will happen with get char also. If you do this ch equals to get char, and then you do a equals to get char, so the same problem happens with the get char also, because it works like same as a, suppose I give r, you can see that only r value is taken, the other value is not taken. Okay, so to solve this we have a function named ch equals to get ch, the another function of this category, where you only get the character and you are not required to print any, you are not required to give the, you are not required to give enter as a command. Okay, so here command is not enter button. Okay, it does not require any command. Okay, let us see how it runs. If I run it and I give r, if I give r, you can see that two r's were taken. Okay, let us run it again. The problem, there is a problem, but I will show you what is the solution of this problem. See properly, I give first input as u and the second input as h. So you can see u and h, but you never saw anything written on the screen when I pressed u and then I pressed h. Both of them you could not see. Okay, so get ch is a character inputting the function which does not print anything on the screen. Okay, so it directly takes the input u. First I take u and then it took h. Okay, now if you want to see the input also on the screen, so we have another variation of this function which is called get che. Okay, so get che simply means e stands for echo. Fine, e stands for echo. So it, echo means showing something. So when I run this and I give input as r, okay, you can see here that this is given. I am not required to put enter or anything. I will just give the input g. Okay, so you can see r g was given as input and r hyphen 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 g is used, is printed as printf. So if I want to print it in a new line, so I will put this new line over here. Okay, and let us do again a formatting. Then again I run, if I give input as d and small m, so you can see the d and small m are output. Okay, so whenever you are using two, you want to have two characters one after the other as input, so always use get che as the input function. Okay, so what we see in this particular lecture video, we saw use of printf, use of scanf, use of get char, get ch and get che. We also saw the variations and the conversions between integers and characters. The same method can be available, the same input methods are available of for integer and float both. Okay, and for characters we are doing input. You can do scanf if a single character is there. Scanf is a very good option with percent c, but if there are two continuous integer inputs or two continuous character inputs, then scanf is a dangerous to use, and similarly get char is also dangerous to use. So in that case you have to use get ch or get che. Okay, get ch is a bit confusing because you don't see the output on the screen, but get che you will also see the whatever you are inputting is also seen on the screen. Okay, so we will see in next video. Till then, thank you.